And now it's time for some hockey action right here on Hockey TV. Again, I'm your host, Kevin Bryant, for this telecast between the LA Traffic, which will be our home team in the white jerseys, and the Chicago MsConduct team in the black uniforms. Looks like in the pipes we have down for LA, number 82. My glasses don't deceive me. And number 13, my favorite number, birthday number for me, for the Chicago MsConduct in the pipes. So we'll have a 15-minute period here. Then after the first two periods, we'll cut the ice again and have the final 15 minutes to wrap up this contest. 16 going off against number 87 for LA. Quick whistle there. A couple players dropped into the circle before the puck actually even touched the ice. I think our officials are even trying to warm up here on Hockey TV. Got a full slate of games for you all day, and now the puck is finally dropped. So I hope you have some time on your hands. And if you happen to be traveling, just tune us in on your favorite device. And tell a friend to go to HockeyTV.com. Check out some of our different type of all-access plans. You can definitely access a ton of hockey hours, over 100,000 hours, I'm told. Man, if you got that much time, you really love some hockey. So, this LA team now in the white jerseys going up against Chicago. Chicago here in the traveling uniforms. A big collision there. No foul, though. Might get our first icing call. Nope. Right off the boards, and LA gets possession of the puck. Back up the ice comes number 3 for Chicago. She sends it over. Stolen over there in mid-ice, coming in over and slapped out of the crease area by number 1 on Chicago, their defender. Puck gets out of the offensive zone. Here's a little bit of a breakout. 91, one of the defensive men, comes into the corner. She's actually going to go in and take a shot and score! Wow, didn't waste any time finding the back of the net on the first shot on goal there for Chicago. They'll take an early 1-0 lead in this contest. That goal coming at 13:44 on the game clock. And the first period off the blade of number 91. Again, we're going to try to keep track of these two teams based on their uniform numbers because we don't happen to have the official game rosters. 91 again with the puck. She's already found the back of the net. Puck goes down just below the goal line there for Chicago. They gain possession of the puck. 16 swims behind the back of the net. Out to the point. A little harmlessly shot down, blocked away by the stick of the goalkeeper. And back up the ice comes LA, sending it out of their defensive zone. Chicago gains possession back of the puck, and they send it in. A little dump and chase route there by 78. Almost a good pass to herself with the ricochet off the corner of the boards. Now quickly back up ice comes 87. She's taken off the puck there by Chicago as they send it back into their offensive zone and make a line change. So Chicago gets on the board off their first shot on the goal off of the blade of number 91. Finding the back of the net, here's LA with the steal. Gains possession of the puck, trying to get their first offensive opportunity. Chicago's defense looks stellar so far. Clearing the puck just like that out of their defensive zone. There's some forecheck going on by 86. She gets the puck up for a teammate, number 4 for Chicago. Now back up the ice comes number 23 for LA Traffic. Swinging around on the boards. Eats that puck without a shot on goal. There's a shot that's just to the glove side of number 13 in the pipes for Chicago. 11:55 on our game clock here in the first period. I'm Kevin Bryant here on Hockey TV's coverage of the USA Nationals, Girls Tier 1 Nationals. And we're coming to you from Rochester Onyx Arena. Hope you have a full plate of food in front of you, eating some good vittles by Mom. I know I wish I did. Some eggs and bacon and hash brown and maybe even a bowl of grits sound good to KB right now. And I say KB, you can follow me on Twitter at KB Sports Guy if you're into that type of thing. And if you want to leave a comment, go ahead. I always answer some of the folks out there. Especially do if you're nice and kind to a guy. We'll have a stoppage of play there, no penalty. But we'll have a face-off out in neutral ice. 11:23 on our game clock here in the first period. You're watching Hockey TV's coverage between this Chicago MsConduct in the black uniforms leading the LA traffic off of their first shot on goal off the blade of one of the defensemen, number 91. Now 16 takes it in for Chicago. Sends that puck behind the goalkeeper. Now it's stuck along the boards. There's a quick shot off of 16th stick. There's 13 with a big opportunity. Man, the goalie came way out of her crease. Cutting off the angle on that shot off of Chicago's stick. Now LA trying to clear the puck out of their zone. They gain possession. And they swoop it out and try to go make a change. Getting chased at 23. Before that, though, there's going to be a icing call. And we'll go back down the ice for another puck drop inside the Chicago offensive zone. So 10:36 on the clock. In the first period here, myself and my cameraman Eric are up on the scaffolding just to the right of the bench of Chicago. Got a great vantage point up here to see some hockey all day long. We'll be covering 8 total games for you on Hockey TV, so get used to this voice. I'm going to be your new friend for the day. 86 for Chicago loses her apparatus. She scoops down and picks up the stick as number 4 weaves her way around traffic coming up ice. Now she's at center ice, weaving in and out, unleashes a big shot. It's just wide of number 81, the netminder for the traffic. Now 87 for the traffic, bangs a little old side pass off of the boards. It's sent back in by Chicago. Right now, just as a quick analysis, Chicago is a bit more alert. Some more crisp passing. And just to seem to be ready for this contest, this early morning contest here in Rochester. Puck dropped at 8:25 in the morning. Not sure if they play. I'm a Michigander, so I know we get up early to play hockey here. We have early morning hockey leagues all across this great state. You might find guys out on the ice at 5 o'clock in the morning just to get a skate in. There's Chicago back up the ice at 78. She's the captain for the Chicago team. Taking it in off of the board. She rides it behind the net, trying the centering pass. It goes behind the goalkeeper. Now 4 weaves her way back in, sending the puck around. Actually, Chicago, don't see that too often, but they make a change with possession of the puck. Puck not able to be cleared out of the defensive zone by number 4 for the traffic. And 4 for Chicago has it. She bangs it back inside with the pass that is stolen, and back up the ice comes L.A. 91's already had a goal. She takes possession of the puck and goes across her blue line, sends a centering pass. Right on the stick of 86. She loses a wheel, though, and possession of the puck. Back up the ice comes 88 for traffic. Flanked by number 8. And here comes 91. She's already found the back of the net again. There's a steal. 17 for the traffic. Tries a backhanded shot. That's off of the padding of the goalkeeper. There's a centering pass. Number 8 was right inside the crease. Couldn't get her hand or her stick on that puck. Biscuit now goes back over to Chicago. They'll regroup here with 7:50 on our game clock in the first period. Hope you're enjoying our coverage of this girls' USA Hockey Tier 1 National Tournament here on Hockey TV. Puck slam back down inside. Chicago's really possessed the puck well. Several shots on goal. First one finding the back of the net. That's always nice. Now both teams, after that first 5 minutes of skating, kind of settled into their respective grooves, if you may. Puck sent down the ice, and we'll have an icing call. And it looks like the official, well, nice kick. Yeah, showing some skills there. Don't want to get down and grab the puck, huh? I like that, Mrs. Official. All right, we'll have a puck drop just to the right of the L.A. traffic goal. Right in the middle of that face-off circle. Puck is dropped. Backhanded shot there by 4. 86 gets another backhanded shot that's going to be scooped up in a glove save there by the netminder. LA traffic in the white uniforms, red lettering, and the Chicago MsConduct team and the all-black unis. Puck is dropped. Just under 7 minutes remaining here in the first period. These periods only 15 minutes long, so they move along pretty quickly. And in this contest, we haven't had any penalties so far. Nice 87. Took a big spill there. Comes up, tried to gain possession of the puck, but back up the ice comes Chicago. Really a 4-on-2 breakaway here. 4 takes the puck all the way into the doorstep, and it's stymied by the goalkeeper. Good job there, falling down and really getting no opening. Was number 91 in the pipes for the LA traffic. Uh-oh. Cameraman almost lost his monster right down onto the game ice. That might have been too funny for me to handle. Back to live action. Don't mind this pole from our scaffolding. I know it's in the middle of your view when we're shooting down ice. Again, we're just to the right of the bench area for Chicago, so we'll give you a great view when we come here near ice. But sometimes we would love to give you some great angles here on Hockey TV. We just got to build a scaffolding that doesn't have a pole right in the center of our cameraman. So 6:13 on the clock. Puck getting dropped inside the LA defensive zone. They gain possession of the draw. Sends it outside the zone. The Chicago team has really put the pressure on here in this first period. Really hammering away at the net, finding one goal, and here's a breakaway opportunity for LA. Good job by 91 for the Chicago team, getting back and cutting off and taking that puck right off of the stick of the LA traffic player. Now LA regroups, mid-ice now, shot sent in right to the net, blocked away harmlessly to the side, and corralled there by 3. She goes around the board. A little forecheck going on there by 17. Gain possession of the puck. Now both players go into the back of the board here. A little communication going on for this LA team, but they don't have the ice really spread out kind of evenly. Kind of hard right, if you may. You're finding too many players in the same position. You're not allowed to, well, you're allowed to, but it's kind of difficult to find some open ice to gain a good successful shot at the net. And just like that, Chicago gains possession of the puck. Sends it around the board with 3 to 86. She steams up the ice, far right side, puts on the brakes with a move and a shot. The pad save, and an open net for 4. She just missed it high to the left side. 4:40 on the clock here as LA comes back up ice. LA still haven't had a lot of shots on goal to number 13, the netminder for Chicago. It's got a good job of her defensive players in front of her, making sure that she doesn't see too much action here in this first period. Here's a steal by number 38. That's what I'm talking about. This Chicago defense just shows up on the spot. Here's a breakaway. One-on-one opportunity whipped on it by 16, I believe. As 17 for Chicago corrals the puck. This MsConduct team has been on fire here as far as possession. Here they go again, once again inside their offensive zone. 16 can't corral the puck. It's on a slippery surface, though, too. Off of the board, 38 sends the puck bouncing behind the net to see if the ricochet will do her some love. It doesn't. It bounces on the stick of traffic. L.A. traffic now trying to get the puck around the rink there, and now they'll be able to clear it. Oh, number 4 whiffs on it. Picked up ice by number 16 as MsConduct makes the change. 16 just sends it in around the rink. Big collision there. Sorry if I got too loud in the microphone. Ouch-a-roni. Man, that hurt me up here. And it looks like one of the traffic players really took the most of that contact out of 86. Both players didn't see one another, and they collided big time. Just a reminder, if you are watching us on Hockey TV, you can save any of your, if you have one of those great all-access plans, I should say, you can save any of the highlights, and you can make your own highlight reel from all of the action here at the USA Hockey Girls Tier 1 National Tournament. So we're going to pause here while the bench area attends to the injured player. Hopefully she's okay, but right now, man, she really took a major hit to right up into the head area. So we're hoping that we don't have any type of concussions. You know, you see a lot of concussions in many sports nowadays, and that's why one of the reasons we don't have checking in this level of play. Still trying to make her way over to the ice. It looks good sportsmanship from this MsConduct team. Hoping that she's okay. Can't even get a number right now, so not going to attribute that to anyone. Just one of the LA traffic players is helped off the ice and may even have to go back to the locker room to get refreshed before rejoining her teammates. 3:23 on our game clock here. You're watching Hockey TV's coverage of the USA Hockey Girls Tier 1 Nationals. And now the officials get back on the ice. Both teams had an extended break there. Sure, they're not upset about the break, but of course, not just the L.A. traffic players, but this MsConduct team, of course, is worried a little bit about the injured player that just exited the ice. Just 3:23 remaining here in the first period. Puck is dropped and action's back on. You never know how teams will respond after something like that happens. Sometimes it lights a fire on the team that's trailing. And the other team that's in the lead sometimes takes their foot off the gas pedal when there's an injured player. Here's 23 zooming in. Oh, what a move there. Shot just wide after the spinorama from 23 for the traffic. Chicago clears it out of their zone in the mid-ice. Taking back possession goes L.A. They come back in. Again, 17 for Chicago. Clears that puck back outside. 87 now goes across ice over the 23. She takes a mid-look. Goes and fires right at the goalkeeper. Took it right inside the breadbasket. Stood tall for that block. Now 23 behind the net. Has two players. She tries the centering pass to 17. Here's 4 with a big slap shot. Redirected off of 18's blade from MsConduct. And now that pass comes on the top side of the net. Blocker save there. Actually, a pad save from the netminder from Chicago. And the puck gets sent up ice. Not going to be any type of icing. Waved off as the Chicago team makes some changes, as well as L.A., getting another fresh line of skaters on the ice. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the first period. Chicago now with possession. Mid-ice is turned back over to L.A. L.A. player whipped on it there. Number 8, stolen here. Mid-ice goes 87. She comes or weaves her way in. She has some help. She sends the puck in behind the net. It goes bouncing right to 13, the goalkeeper. She sticks it away from the net. 91 for this MsConduct team. Scoots up to the puck. Sends it over to 17. Now 49 with a little bit of breakaway. Has 91, actually 78 on her right side. She takes a shot at the net that's wide off of the board behind the goalkeeper. Going to be a penalty coming up. Penalty's going to get assessed to the LA traffic team as they gain possession of the puck. We'll keep an eye on the official as she makes her way over to the scorer's table. Going to be a checking call. 2-minute minor for the LA. Number 87, one of the forwards, goes in for a 2-minute breather in the send-in. So we got 1:26 remaining on our game clock here in the first period of this match between the LA traffic in the white uniforms and the MsConduct team from Chicago and the black unis. Again, I just want to inform our listeners and viewers out here that I'm going to go with the numbers on the jerseys of our players because I just wasn't able to obtain the official rosters. And there's nothing like saying the wrong player's name. Can't get the number wrong. So we're going to go with that. LA comes down on the breakaway. 23 tries to get her stick on the blade as they try to kill this penalty. They spread out in a 1-2-1 zone defense here. Chicago takes it in, right side of the net. Four with it out top. Here are PA announcer. Great speaker system here, but I tell you, they need to turn up the volume. Got 12 speakers in here, and it sounds like the PA announcer's talking off of Charlie Brown's wah-wah-wah speaker. But I did make it out that we're in our final minute of play here in the first period. Chicago leading, 1-0. On the first shot on the game from stick of 91, she gains the puck right there. Chicago regrouping for one more charge here before the end of the period. They are on the power play. 91 swooping in. She's taking off the puck right at the doorstep. Now she slings the puck over into the corner into the far side. Puck is cleared outside of the zone. It's going to get chased down. Only 10 seconds remaining here in the period as 3 tries to zoom around. Maybe make one last ditch effort before we'll hear the horn, and it doesn't look like that'll happen. So, we will come to the end of the first period. This Chicago MsConduct team leads 1-0. We're going to take a quick 2-minute break, and we'll return here on Hockey TV with the second period. And welcome back to Hockey TV's coverage of the Girls Tier 1 USA Nationals. We're coming to you from Rochester, Michigan, just 25 miles north of downtown Detroit. Puck is dropped here as the two teams switch in for the beginning of the second period. Chicago MsConduct team scored on the first shot on goal off of the stick of number 91. This LA team now trying to kill this penalty that they got in the ending moments of the first period. Two players go to the back of the ice, and wow, there's a goal. I had a great vantage point there. 78, she came in on the power play opportunity, went to her knees, glanced up, 16 on her squad, wide open, open net. Goalkeeper number 91 for LA did not notice her, and that was one of the easier goals you'll see. And a great vantage point from our angle up here. So, a power play goal for Chicago as they go up 2-0 over the LA traffic team. Puck is dropped. That goal was scored at the 4:26 mark here in the second period. Chicago capitalizing on their first opportunity in the overtime period. Again, we're going to go with the jersey numbers of the players. Boy, number 45 was just pinned up on the boards there for LA. They finally get the puck and they send it up ice. Number 13 swallows it up there for Chicago. She's in between the pipes and doing a good job so far. And actually, I'm going to attribute the lack of shots she's seen to the defense has been just swarming for Chicago. Once LA gains possession of the puck, they'll take it into their offensive zone, and Chicago does just some poke checking and maybe some hip checking, but they'll take the puck right off of the blades of these LA traffic players. So Chicago wins the draw. We're back up ice. Going to have an icing call. Two teams will skate down to the opposite end for the puck drop. Again, I'll be your host all day long here on Hockey TV for certain games coming from this Rochester Onyx Arena. Follow me on Twitter at KBSportsGuy. That's my handsome face you see out there. Yeah, I'm not bashful. And here comes up Ice Coast Chicago. They'll send the puck in over the goal line. Number 78 will scream a shot. Front side of the net. They can get the puck up. Now 23 has a breakaway for LA. She goes in, and that's not an opportunity. 23 didn't do a lot of deking as she gained possession of the puck on the breakaway. Caught Chicago in a line change there. And just went strong side trying to catch the goalie napping. And a shot goes right up into her breadbasket. And now we'll have a drop-off, 86 going against 87 for the traffic team. Up the ice comes number 16. Actually, that's number 6. 86 comes down and scoops it up. She tries to wing it back down low, below the goal line. 86 gets a stick on it in between the circle. Puck is kept in by Chicago. Backhanded opportunity is stolen by 87 and taken out of the offensive zone. And now LA will gain control of the puck. Number 1 sends it around the ice. 8 gets it and she sends it up the ice now. A couple of the LA players look like they're a bit winded. You're able to bring 20 players onto this tournament roster. And these teams are more of the variety of a, not just a traveling club team, but a very experienced, and you don't want to say recreational team, because these ladies definitely have some skills. We'll have a stoppage of play on that shot. 91, the goalkeeper for the traffic team, had that one all swallowed up on her pipe, on her padding there. Looks like the puck will get dropped to her right side, 12:15 on the game clock. 8 for traffic is going to go against number 16, who just found the back of the net for the Chicago. MsConduct squad. Chicago gains possession of the puck. It's precariously sitting out in front. Number 16 again off of her stick, just wide right. 91 now shuts the door in the pipes as LA tries to clear it out of their zone. They do. Clearing pass is intercepted there by Chicago. Chicago in the black unis. They send it back down. Communication by the goalkeeper letting her wingers know where the traffic is coming in at. LA is going to have to do a better job here, and here they'll have an opportunity. Taking it up ice, a player right in the center, unable to get the centering pass to number 88. As Chicago gains possession of the puck, screaming in shot off of the pads, and it's going to get saved by this MsConduct. Number 13 in the pipes, number 13 on the program. You fill in the blank on the name. Again, I'm working up here on the broadcast, sans the roster, so I'm going to go with our numbers. Apologize about that, but sometimes if you hear me on some of these broadcasts, you know that I struggle sometimes with the pronunciation of last names. Anyway, now we go live action. LA with the puck. First time they've had an extended period of time. 23 has been all over the ice for LA in this second period. Several breakaway opportunities. She slams in and takes the puck off of the blade of a MsConduct player. That puck will find just over the bench area of Chicago out of play, and we'll have a stoppage of play. Nice smile from the coaching staff down there. Didn't get no harm, no foul. Didn't get touched with that biscuit. I know it's early morning. That's not the type of biscuit anybody wants to get hit with. Now LA with the puck, 87 goes inside. No offsides call there. 87 goes down to the ice, and we'll have a stoppage of play, and it looks like we'll have a hooking call. At 10:44 on the clock, MsConduct will have their first penalty of the game going into the send-ins, number 17, for 2 minutes for hooking. Big opportunity for LA traffic to get back into this contest. Puck is dropped just to the right of the goalkeeper, setting up their offense. Slowly but surely, you'll see a couple players down inside the crease. Number 1 and number 23 is up on top, trying to get the puck down low. One sends it down inside. Rebound goes behind the netting area. Now it's kept in by one off of her skate. She backhands it down inside off of the boards into the corner. 3 gains possession of the puck. She's swarmed there by one of the traffic players going to the net. She sends a shot in. Looks like we may have another penalty. I saw one of the refs coming up with her hand up in the air. Contact to the LA traffic player getting shoved down to the ice. But we won't have a call. Just a fresh draw here with 1:24 remaining on the penalty here for LA traffic. 23 swings around. She sends a shot high, back of the net. 87 scoops it out of the corner. Backhands it out to the point. Number 1, the defenseman, sends it across ice to 23. Big slap shot there. Pad save by the goalkeeper on the back of the boards. Now it goes over in the corner. Number 1 for this traffic team sends it back up ice. This MsConduct team killing this penalty with only 46 seconds remaining. 38 weaves in. Not a real big opportunity as only 2 wingers come down inside the zone, not allowing a breakaway because they're only got 4 players on the ice, and the penalty here for just 25 more seconds is this MsConduct squad. They possess the puck. They send it up ice. May get an icing call. Officials look at one another. It's stopped by the goalkeeper, 91. So no icing call. As the final 10 seconds of the penalty, LA trying to mount one more rush here. 23, quickly up into the offensive zone and banging on the ice. You know that that penalty is about to expire. Now both teams are at full strength. So unfortunate there for this LA traffic squad trying to get back in this match. They trail 1-0. Off of, I'm sorry, 2-0, 91, first goal, and then it was number 16 with a big open net, and she just dug it home to open this second period while MsConduct was on the power play. Both teams trying to make a change here, at least LA is now, they do. 7-1 defenseman sends the puck in. It's blocked out top by 17 from the MsConduct team. Here's 86 coming out, trying to catch up with the puck as 91 comes out of the pipes, sends it around. 86 now on the doorstep. It's timed there off of the padding of number 91, the goalkeeper for LA. Back with the puck in her offensive zone. She'll backhand it inside, make a quick change. Number 7, one of the bigger players out on the ice for LA. She's one of the defensemen. Big stick there. Sends it up to 86. 17 finds a player. Number 1 going down to scoop up that opportunity. 16 for the Conduct squad comes into ice, weaving between two players, drop shot or drop pass there to number 9. Number 49 on the shot there from MsConduct. It's swallowed up in the pipes by 91. We'll have a face-off just to the right of the traffic team. 16 and 87 in the circle. Draw is controlled by Chicago. 16 now comes into the corner. Battling 23. I'm just going to call her Miss Wheels. She has some big speed. That LA traffic player. 16 with a good shot. Went to her power side there. And a stick save by the goalkeeper. Here's a wraparound opportunity by 78. Unable to crack the door, but she was knocking on the doorstep hard. Now this LA team has a breakaway if they can get the puck up ice. 23 had possession. She did have a teammate, 87, that was sprinting away, but she could not get the puck off of her blade. Now this puck is sent back inside as Chicago makes a quick change. 16 remains on the ice for them. 86 now gains the possession in her offensive end, trying to swing in around. Coming in onside, and it looks like it was number 3 on the shot. One of the captains for, actually it was number 4, one of the captains for MsConduct, unable to get a clean shot on goal. It's banged back down by 86 over the goal line, swung around the rink. And that centering pass off of 4, can't get through all the defense. This defense for LA is really picked up here in the second period. They did surrender a goal, but they were a man down to begin the period, and since then, they've done a good job of possessing the puck and getting a couple shots on net. And here's on the doorstep. Oh, what a block. 4 came in with the block. Goalkeeper went down to the pads, but the puck bounced right back to 86, and she cleans up the business for a goal. Chicago will go up 3-0. Second goal of the period at 5:18 on the game clock. LA's found themselves in a bad position now. Puck is dropped at center ice. The Chicago MsConduct team right back at it. 91, the goalkeeper for LA, swallows that puck up. Glove save there. I think she used a little bit of her stick as well. So we'll have a clean draw between 23 for LA and number 16 for Chicago. Puck is dropped. Scoots outside the offensive zone. Neutral zone ice. Sit back in and out of play, actually. Oh, actually, it was a quick offsides call. Number 878 for MsConduct. could not exit it, her offensive end. And hey, you're taught since a young player that when you have an opportunity to put your blade on that biscuit, you do it, no matter where you're at. You see that in a lot of sports nowadays, too. Players are sometimes just not aware of out-of-bounds lines or blue lines or infractions. So, 78 once again. And you can see the trepidation on her face. She's kind of upset at herself. Saw her forward, and I want to say that was 16, steaming into the offensive zone and just inadvertently stuck her stick down and touched it, and we'll have an offsides call. Puck dropped just outside the blue line. Controlled there by Chicago. They sent it into their offensive zone. The offense of Chicago has been on fire here in this match. Only 4:34 remaining here in the second period. Chicago leading 3-0. For LA to change the tables and turn the tables into this match, you're going to have to get some good fortune and luck. This might be it. 88. Should take a shot. Kind of a blocker save. As well as a glove bat down by the goalkeeper, number 13 for MsConduct team. They come back up ice over the blue line. There's a shot blocked out top. And the rebound by 78. She'll take it in for the goal. So to recap our goals here. Second period, this Chicago MsConduct team scores their third goal of the period. Had one goal by 16, one goal by number 86 there, and one by 78. Chicago with 4:04 on the game clock leads this contest handily so far. They possess the puck longer than LA and a lot more shots on goal, and they're right back at it. There's a player gets tripped up coming into the offensive end. 23 for this traffic team. She's got major wheels as a defense player. You can see it because she has that long blade out there. But she definitely knows how to get up and down the ice in a hurry. Puck slammed around the boards there. LA trying to get back in this match. They're desperate now. Going to have to start taking some chances to put some pressure on this Chicago team. This MsConduct team is giving the business right now to this LA traffic squad. Pucks in down into the offensive zone. Chicago goes in to make a change. 18. She comes in and shadows 45, tries to apply a forecheck, loses the wheel there. Back up the ice comes LA traffic, 88 with it. She steams over to the right side, left side of the goalkeeper, sending a centering pass and unable to get a blade on it. Now to quickly turn around for 78. She'll have a one-on-one breakaway opportunity. Got one shot off of her stick, and it was a pad save by 91. Beautiful save there. We'll get an icing call here. And it was waved off by the near side, the official. So Chicago will try to take back possession of the puck. One of the LA players gets wounded and goes down to the ice. Chicago back up ice. They'll send it in by off the blade of 6. Nice pass there. She sends it around the rink all the way and kept in by number 49, one of the captains for the Chicago team. Just under 2 minutes remaining here in the second period. Remember, in this girls' Tier 1 event or tournament, we clean and cut the ice after the end of the second period. We'll have a short break, give you an opportunity to refresh yourself, maybe visit the old wherever you need to visit. Get yourself ready for the third and final period. There's a shot going in, and it'll find the back of the net. 91 could not locate it at the initial block. And that goal is going to get attributed to number 91, her second of the night. 91 opened up the scoring for this Chicago team. And she'll get the second goal, fourth goal of the second period. Chicago's really put the gas on and have found the net four times here in the second period. 91 has seen a lot of shots coming at her from a lot of different angles, and that one, the last goal, I'm going to attribute a little of that to fatigue, and maybe not just physical fatigue, because of course these players are in great shape to be playing on this level, but maybe some mental fatigue after seeing so many games, so many shots. So we enter our final minute of play here in the second period of this contest. 78 with it. Beautiful centering pass. Just in front of number 4. Could not get her stick on it. 4 sends it back down into the corner. 16. She'll scoop it up to 78. Two players in front of the ice. It's a good job of screening out 91, the netminder. The shot went to the wide side. Errant pass there by Chicago. It exits out of their offensive zone. They still gain possession of the puck. Close to being offside. Not called. 87 for this LA team. Now on a breakaway. One-on-one opportunity. She's checked right off of the puck there by number 16 for the MsConduct squad. So we'll come to the final seconds. And there's the horn. The Chicago MsConduct squad letting LA know who the boss was, scoring 4 big goals to take a 5-1 lead, as we'll pause for the cause, take a breather, and come back for the third period. Don't go anywhere. You're watching Hockey TV. And welcome back to Hockey TV's coverage of this USA Girls Tier 1 event coming to you from Rochester Onyx Ice Arena. I'm Kevin Bryant. Puck just dropped for the beginning of the third period. Chicago came away with 4 goals in the second period to really open up this contest. For LA, they're going to have to work hard to get back into it. Now back up ice come Chicago in the black uniforms. And the goal is Christina Malzow. Oh, and there is a quick goal. As I glance down at the rosters that I was just supplied with, quick goal scored there by the Chicago team, extending their lead to 6-0 over LA. This is the women's C division of the USA 2017 Nationals. Chicago team been stellar so far. 2 goals by Ariel Ponquise. Rosalind Sample with a goal. Jessica Varin. And Jessica Vereen just scored her second goal. And I know I'm missing two more goals there, or at least one more goal. I think it was Jessica Dare in the first half. LA team's really been on the schneid this entire game. First shot was actually scored by Ariel Pontikas. Took the puck up the ice, found the back of the net. Now Chicago lurking again. Puck is scooped up there by Victoria Pizzuto. Pizzuto now with it. She swings around. Taking off the puck there by 38, Hank. Hank with it now. One-handing, kind of holding off and bracketing the offensive player. Looks like we'll have a penalty coming up against this LA team. Maybe even two penalties coming up against this LA team. And the stoppage of play there. LA can ill afford to have two people visit the box. Looked like one was a check and one was a hold. Let's see which one. We'll have a tripping call on number 45 for LA for 2 minutes. And that is Courtney King. So 12:10 on our game clock. Puck is dropped. Chicago is on the penalty. Four with a big shot off of Jessica Howerton. Up top from the point. Big shot sent down in by Tank. Got Tank out there on the ice for Chicago. Carbus. There's Carbus up top with it as she sends it back down. Goes around Howerton. Two players falling down to the ice there. Now Staple. And the pipes for Chicago. Melissa Sadko. Sadko, actually maybe one of the daughters of the two coaches, Sean and Melissa, the coaches for the MsConduct squad. So it's under 1 minute remaining on the penalty. Chicago tries to do some work as LA comes up the ice. Quickly up the ice goes Miss Wheels. Pizzuto comes in slamming into the net. That's what you call an offensive charge. Still just a couple seconds left on the power play. Chicago sends in the fresh skaters out onto the ice. Pizzuto now with the puck. She crosses over into her offensive zone. Eating out all of the moments of this penalty. Tanka now with the puck as she skirts it around outside into the Chicago zone. Scooped up there by Pontikas. Pontikas sends the puck back down, and the penalty is over. Both teams at full strength. Pontikas sends the puck over. Now 86 with it going up the ice. That would be Staple. Staple lost it as she tried a centering pass over to Howerton, and that will stop it. With 9:53 on the clock, you're watching Hockey TV's coverage of the 27 USA Hockey National Championship. We're coming to you from Rochester, Michigan. Full slate of games today on Hockey TV. This one has really gotten away from the LA traffic squad. Gaining some great ice time, though, against some fierce competition from this Chicago MsConduct squad. There's a shot on goal. Oh, Freckus inside the zone area there in between the crease. Now back up the ice quickly goes Miss Wheels herself. Victoria Pizzuto. Pizzuto. Here's Pizzuto in the corner with the puck. She's taking off of it. 16 for MsConduct is Vereen. She sends it up the ice. L.A. gains possession of the puck. It's scooped up outside. Right now, L.A.'s just trying to set up their offense and try to find the back of the net. You know, Melissa Saduko. Sadko, I should say. Here's a penalty coming up against L.A. again. Not sure if it's a tripping call, but a player went down on the ice. Referee comes in and signals. Looks like that was an interference call. So it'll be a 2-minute penalty on number 45 for the traffic squad as Courtney King sits down in the send-in. 2 minutes. And now we have the puck drop. Pontinkas with the puck now. She sends it over the ice. Scooped up there by Howerton. Howerton sends the puck across the ice. Centering pass. Couldn't find the player she intended. Now here's an opportunity for LA to try to slow down. And that's what sometimes you do when you're on the short end of the power play. You allow your squad to have a breakout opportunity if you take the puck too far inside your own offensive zone, opening up the ice for the team with the more players on the ice. We'll have a face-off coming up down inside the offensive end for Chicago MsConduct squad. Pizzuto takes it and wins the draw for L.A. Going to have to catch up our game clock. We're just a couple seconds off. No worries. No harm. This game is not that close, but you never know. Coming in with some fancy stick work there was Madeline Tank, one of the forwards for Chicago. Showing some real soft hands and then finding the back of the net right over. Malazate is in the pipes for this LA traffic team as they fall behind 7-0. This is the women's C division of the USA Hockey 27 Nationals. Both teams are still playing in pool play. And by the looks of things, Chicago is going to come away with 3 full points and move on to the quarterfinal round. And actually, I'm going to have to check that because they may be in the quarterfinal round. I see 6 teams in this division, 7 teams, so Chicago representing the Central and LA Traffic representing the Pacific. So this is a 10-team tournament. Have to check the format on the break as where these teams stand and their overall play here in this tournament. Back up the ice comes Chicago. Puck scooped up there by Staple. Staple's shot is blocked. Now charging in goes Dudley. Full head of steam comes the LA player. And that was Gloria Wong. going down to the ice was Z for LA. Quickly, Ariel Ponticus with it. She clears it out of her zone. As Wong goes down and she shadows Dudley. Puck moves out of the offensive zone for LA. Scooped up there by Tanka. It's Marshad Tanka. Quick wrister. Saved one time. Rebound still puck loose. Going to allow our clock to tick down and maybe catch up with the official game clock. We'll have a face-off with 5:15 remaining in this contest. 7-0. Chicago MsConduct team. After scoring one goal off of Ponticus in the first period, Chicago exploded, scoring four goals in the second period to take a 5-0 lead. And he put two more, lighting up the net twice here in the third and final period. Ariel Grower, Ronner, like this coloring of her stick tape. They got that Jamaican red, black, and green. Show who you're with, lady. She sends the puck now over to 38 with a spinorama. Going up the ice is Tank. Tank just scored a goal, trying to light up the pipes one more, the light one more time. She's sent away. Slam back into the corner. Finney tries to clean it out of the corner for the traffic squad. Going down to the ice there was Tank. It's a good forecheck. 86, Staple picks up the puck. Has to wait until Tank exits the offensive end. Tank is a little worse for the worry as she limps over into the box. So back up the ice comes L.A. And Blanco with it. She's taking off the puck. Quickly back up the ice comes the Chicago team. That's Vereen. Finney takes the puck. She centers it. Now comes in. Finney to captain with it. Can't corral that bouncing biscuit. Goes just over the goal line. Chicago now gains possession. 3:15 remaining on our game clock here in the third and final period. Chicago relentless on their attack. Entire match they've possessed the puck several, I would say at least 2-1 as far as the amount of time. LA sends the puck back up ice and we'll get ourselves an icing call with 2:42 on the clock. And actually, with the score the way it is, we do have a running clock. Not trying to tire out these ladies too much. And any opportunity for injury. Clock now stops. So I'm not sure what was going on there as far as the running clock. I thought due to the score, the clock was going to continue to run. But it looks like it was a scorer error. So the clock's going to stay there for about 10 seconds. We're about real 2:40 on our clock, our game time. Now it starts to tick down. Under 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining here in the third and final period. Players go down to the ice trying to gain possession as LA kept inside by Tank for the MsConduct squad. Now it's stolen. Stolen there by 49. It would be Flynn. Flynn sends the puck out of the ice. And And now coming back up hard, throwing a change as one of the LA team, and she sends it towards the netting area. And I think that was Gloria Wong on the shot, number 88 for your LA traffic squad. Teams slowly meander back out onto the ice, make a quick change here, trying to skate out this last 1:46 on the clock. Puck has dropped this LA team. Unfortunate throughout the entire match. Not helpful when your opponent scores on the very first opportunity of the match. Here's a breakaway opportunity. Good job of getting back and checking the puck off of the blade of Vereen. Now LA comes across, putting on the brakes, turning, weaving. Victoria Pizzuto had a very good skate here. Pizzuto just didn't have an opportunity to get any real good shots on goal. So just under 1 minute remaining here. This MsConduct team is going to come away with 3 points in this USA Hockey 2017 National Tournament action. We're watching the Women's C Division now right here on Hockey TV. Puck is dropped. It trickles back over the goal line for Chicago. They clean up the miss. Tank goes down to the ice. Now it's 86 with the puck. Staple sends it right over to Flynn. Flynn takes it down into the corner. She bangs it behind the net. Centering pass. Too much traffic for the MsConduct squad. Slap shot, more slapping of the ice there off of Staple's blade. There's a centering pass. Final 25 seconds remaining. The Chicago team on the power play, but they definitely don't need to find the back of the net here. Up by a touchdown over their opponent. We'll go ahead and give some accolades out already because we're counting down the final minutes, and there is the horn. This Chicago MsConduct team will come away with a 7-0 win over LA Traffic. Like, thank you for tuning in to Hockey TV's coverage of the 2017 USA Hockey National Tournament. We have plenty of hockey action right here on Hockey TV all day long. I was your host for this event, Kevin Bryant, and I hope to see you soon. Have a great day, folks.